Hi, similar to what we have done in the single operation in the previous tutorial, in this video tutorial we will learn how to create an empty interact Python part that we can run without error. We will create it in the basic examples folder. Because it's very similar to the single operation, I will copy and modify to save time. You can also copy your single operation file to continue this interaction tutorials. If you don't have a single operation, please file it in a text file. Change the name to strip operation and double click to modify. Firstly, we need to change the script file to strip operation. We will create this file later. Also, change the title. For strip operation, we don't need line parameter, because it will get based on input points, similar to length of column. Actually, this above element is usually wall, not column strip, replace column by wall. That's it. We created a BBB file for strip. Now, turn it to interact with PythonPart. What we need is a tab name interactor. Set the value of this tab to 2. Now ALLPLAN will recognize this PythonPart as an interactive PythonPart. Copy the image with the same name to the library folder. We have done with PBB file. Now we need to create the Python script file. Your Visual Studio Code and open folder PythonPart example scripts, basic examples. Similar to BBB file, we will copy single phrase script and modify. Change name to strip phrase. In create elements function, let's return a table of 2 empty lists like we did in the empty normal Python part. We don't need single phrase in the last anymore. Now let's run the Python part to see what will happen. Error: PythonPart says that function create interactor is not implemented. This happens with the interactive PythonPart if you just use create element function to return empty model. Example, if now I delete this interactor tag and turn the PythonPart back to the normal PythonPart. Run again and it works well. We have the interface without length, and it does nothing if you click. Let's turn to interact PythonPart and modify the script to make it work. Instead of create element, interactive PythonPart must have a function named create interactor. This function is the function where we start the interactor. Now need the createElement function. You can use it for the preview, but not important. To see what we need for this function, let's open the building element input file. In etc PythonPart framework, general scripts, open building element input file. Looking for create interactor. When you run the interactive PythonPart, this function will be called by ALLPLAN, and it will run the create interactor in your script. That's why we must have this create interactor function. Note that there are three types of create interactor function depend on the parameter counts. It can be 3 parameters, 7 parameters, or 8 parameters. Extra parameters will be useful when you create a Python part that can be double-clicked to modify. We will talk about it in another tutorial. Now, let's use the symbol with 3 parameters. The first input is a coordinate input class, the second is a string, and the last one is a string type service class. This variable is the coordinate input class in the input module. Let's import the module first. Then we can write a hint for this variable. This is the string type. This variable is not important currently. We can deep dive in the framework to see the workflow of ALLPLAN and understand what happened in this graph interactor. However, it's quite complicated. So now you just need to understand that this function must return a class. Let's create this class. There are some methods that we must have in this class. First method is RosetMountMSG. Let's take a look at this method in building element input. Here it is. It handles the RosetMountMessage event. Copy it to our class. First input is an integer for mouse message. The second is the input point, and the last one is additional message info. Note that it returns a boolean. Let's return true means success. Second method is onCancel function. Again, check in building element input. This method will trigger when you close the Python part or press escape button. Copy the detail. And return true. It means whenever you press escape button, the Python part will exit. Another method is onMountLeave that handles the MountLeave event. No need to do anything here now. Lastly, a required method is onPrevewDraw that handles the PrevewDraw event. There's some more methods which are important, such as onControlEvent. If you create a button in the interface, this method will help to control the event of the button. Modify element property will trigger whenever you input or modify parameters. That's it. We finished the script for this empty interactive Python part. Let's run it to check. Double click and we see no error. When we press escape button, the Python part exits successfully. Try one more time to update the log file. In the log file, we see no error except the string table error. Don't worry, this string table is used for handle language. We will talk about it later. For now, all look good and we finalize our goal for this lesson. Thank you and see you in the next lesson.